important thing which I will request all financial institutions like SIDBI and banks, that they should have a dashboard. And any person who apply for any scheme, there should be a monitoring system by which we can understand if the project is legitimate and genuine. Still, because of red tabism, it is to be pending there. This is not good. So it is the time of the scrutiny. Every time you need to find out the reason. I remember one incident with the meeting with the all chairman of the banks and the finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman ji. Some of the chairman of them, we have completed our target. I asked them question, who has given you the target? Actually, it is not that you are expecting more finance to MSMEs, more than the target. Why you close the subject? Just because of showing Reserve Bank and government that our target is completed. Then 22% of the cases, which are actually there are pending cases were there when we inquire about it, the jurisdiction of the bank was not on that area. So immediately they can transfer that case to the area where the area of jurisdiction of the bank, the branch which they have, they can transfer the case, but nothing will happen. So these are the small things. By monitoring, we need to help the legitimate and genuine MSMEs as early as possible. We should have a transparent digital policy, fast-track decision-making process, time-bound decision-making process, and the performance audit of the different MSMEs and the schemes, and which is very important. Actually, the role of non-banking financial institutions is also equally important. They are also financing on large scale to MSMEs, the small people, and we need to encourage them. And this is the time that we need to find out exactly the capable entrepreneurs where we can help them as a financial supporter, as a technology provider, and as we can support them for the markets, and we can make the success story of them. The people, particularly scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, socially, economically, educationally backward, where we need to develop more jobs. Without creating jobs, we cannot eradicate the poverty. And eradicate of poverty is the mission for the government. And the dream of our Honorable Prime Minister, Narendra Modi ji, is to make Indian economy as a number one global economy in the world. Without MSME's contribution, we cannot do it. We have decided to make MSME contribution in GDP, taking from 30% up to 40%. 48% presently export we have. Our target is to make it 60% of the export from MSME. And up till now, we have created 11 crore jobs. Now we are planning to develop 5 crore new jobs. We need to develop more exports. And we need to find out which are the fields where we are importing the material. The people like your chamber, SIDBI, institutions, they can find out what are the things which you are importing. Is it possible for us to make that all the imported material which we are importing, we can make it in India, made in India. We can support them for that. And that can be possible. On the basis of that, we need to focus the target. We need to reduce the imports and increase the export. We need to concentrate on agriculture, rural, tribal and under-equipped aspirant districts and socially, economically, educationally backward entrepreneurs, people, particularly scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and minorities. And we need to create entrepreneurship between them and give them all type of facility, finance and technology by which they can stand on their own. And without that, we cannot make India Atmanirbhar Bharat. So this is the time. The huge potential is available. People are doing a lot of excellent jobs like your chamber. You are taking initiative, out-of-box thinking, helping to the people. This is very important. And now I am also trying to make a dashboard in my ministry by which I can monitor bank, SIDBI, all the people who are applying for it, It is very unfortunate for me when I am taking review in the Spurti and other schemes. 6 to 7 years it is taking to for approval. What is this? In the lifespan, if you give 7 years time for approval, what is this? I was very much annoyed about it. The people who are not working, I am suggesting take VRS, otherwise I will terminate you from the services. And I am giving them the target. And I request to CMD, CDB also, after the application within 3 months, you take the decision and support him. After application in any government scheme within 3 months, you decide and give him support. If there is a delay more than 3 months, it's not good. And it is the problem with the bureaucracy, they are making complicated schemes. This is from the state, this is from the district, this is from the deputy director. And no one has habit to take the decision at an appropriate time. The time is the most important capital in the business. And the people, those who are getting salary every month, they never understand the importance of time. And I am sorry for that. We have to make time-bound approach for all our schemes, incentives and other things. And that is exactly the important thing for all stakeholders and also for the government. By which we can have to make the system digitalized, making dashboards. Financial audit is important, but performance audit is very important. You find out where are the delays and you have to help to the people and find out the people, those who are making delays, those who are not taking the decisions, either suggest them for VRS or terminate them from the services. This type of non-performing assets who are in the administration, they are not useful for the country and for the nation. So this is the time by all of us to make our system transparent, time-bound, result-oriented and performance-oriented and helping to the appropriate entrepreneurs, those have good track record. Always, I have already requested you to giving me the scheme by which we can make the rating of the MSMEs and it can be easy for all of us to support them. The financial institution will support them immediately after receiving their rating. So 100% that will be easy. Now we have fund by which MSME can go to the capital market and they will get 15% equity from our side and other amount they can raise from the capital market. That can be a great thing. In the world, they have already developed insurance economy, pension economy and share economy. But in India, we have a lot of opportunities and a lot of abilities by which we can develop this economy. Where I will request the Honorable CMD of CDB also, that these are the new scheme where we can give opportunity to some MSMEs to go for capital market. And that can be a great thing. And the foreign, particularly the world, whole world now want to invest in Indian industries. Those MSMEs have good track record of turnover, GST and income tax and by the system by which we can give them the rating, they will get good investment from abroad. Chamber is doing excellent job. I know that we have given a lot of opportunity when in the big program you present your presentation to me. So 100% our government is giving highest priority for development of MSME in the country. The rural agriculture in the tribal area, these are the MSMEs which are very important. The food processing, pre-cooling plant, cold storage and different type of raw material which is available in the forest area. On the basis of that we can plan for new technology, new innovations and new research. Which there is an import substitute, cost effective, pollution free and indigenous. We can convert waste into wealth. And even we can make research study about a different type of industries and markets. On the basis of that, if we can give an appropriate vision to the new entrepreneurs by which they can start their own business and they will be benefited. One thing is absolutely correct that our Guptaji is giving reference about the tender process and other thing. We will consider that. But my suggestion is if you have a good quality, good packaging and delivery on time, you don't need government support. Now the whole world is now interested to make collaborations with Indian industries. Upgradation of the technology is very important. And quality is the most important issue, 101% good quality. And without compromise with the quality, we have to reduce the cost, production cost. For that reason, we need to reduce the technology cost, we need to reduce the labor cost, we need to reduce the power cost. Now we have already have a SIDBI has taken a scheme that every MSME, they on rooftop, they will have a solar panels by which they can reduce their bill of electricity. But we need cooperation from the state government for that. So there are to save money is to earn money. So how we can use value addition for different type of raw material, waste material from the MSMEs? How we can make good quality of material from that? How we can reduce the cost of production, cost of the different thing which we need for that? That is exactly the most important thing. And making the collaboration with the world best technology, we need to improve the quality. Without compromise with the quality, we need to reduce the cost. Regarding logistic cost, we are making pre-cooling plant, post-storage, logistic parks from NHAI. The Commerce Ministry is also doing a lot of things. And that is the reason that we can reduce the logistic cost. If we use LNG as a fuel for truck transport, we can reduce the logistic cost by 25% to 30%. If we can use electric trucks, then we can reduce the logistic cost by 60% to 70%. In place of diesel, if we can use CNG, we can reduce the cost. So these are the options which are now the technology is proven. Now Amazon has taken a decision, taking all their transport fleet on electricity. So such type of new innovation, it is the time for the country that we need support from the financial institutions like SIDBI and banks.